you're a voracious reader. Any book that's had a profound impact on you, either career-wise, diplomacy-wise, or even otherwise, personally?
Well, lot of books, because I do read a lot. But if I were to say, reinterpret your question to say, a book which I would have repeatedly read, you know, 25 times, 50 mm-hmm. times kind of thing. Probably two. One is Mahabharata. Mm-hmm. I carry a copy on my travels. I read it often. I have multiple versions. I have a whole bookshelf of variations of it, including some of the multiple volume editions. Maybe Lord of the Rings.
Lord of the Rings.
Those would be the two which I've read most often.
You're a Tolkien fan?
Very much.
Oh, interesting. So what's your favorite character from LOTR?
In Lord of the Rings?
Yeah, in Lord of the Rings.
I would say really... probably on balance, and this comes down a bit to the cricket-like thing. Probably Legolas.
Oh, nice!
Because he's the calm guy.
Yeah.
You know, he's the guy who keeps, you know, things are falling apart. Somebody has to
hold it together.
Hold it to, and that's maybe it's my profession.
Yeah. You know? Music? Are you into music? And the music is in the air these days because of Natu Natu and the Oscar for it. You of course made a famous reference to Tony Blair recently, gave him a bit of a poke. Is there any, you know, favorite album, favorite artist?
No, look, we were a household. My interest in international relations actually came out of music.
Came through music.
Yeah, household. Because when I was very young, my grandparents and then my parents brought international music home, I mean, through records,
nice.
And then encouraged. We used to listen to radio and all that. So, for me, when I first thought about the world, I first thought about the world in terms of the music that I heard from the world, to some extent, the books that you got. Mm-hmm. So, it was, I mean, this was a time when there was no TV, remember?
Yeah, correct.
Okay. So, there was no TV, there was nothing which anybody modern would, you know, anybody today, contemporary, young, would identify as a connect with the world.
Yeah.
So it was largely radio, it was books. So for me, you know, my international sense was also music. And even within India, and my parents were deeply interested in music. My mother actually had a degree in music.
Oh, wow.
So we would have somebody playing MS in one room and Lata Mangeshkar in another, and somebody would be trying to, you know, put a Beethoven on the gramophone on the other side. So that was the house.
Nice. So finally, as we round up, I mean, you've been a diplomat since 1977, 78, for the last 40, 45 years now. Surely there must have been a diplomat or multiple diplomats who have impacted you profoundly, your most favorite diplomat, as it were.
You know, that's a question I'd pass, because look, I had a mentor, I would say, in the Foreign Service, mm-hmm. To whom I actually dedicated my book, who really, you kind of are an understudy to somebody when you join,
yeah,
and he was, I think, enormously helpful in shaping my early years. And this was a person called Arvind Dev. So in personal terms, I would say he is someone, you know, a lot of my thinking, my sense of tutelage goes back to him. I had some very, very good bosses, I mean, who were the kind of legends of the Indian Foreign Service. There was a gentleman called Shankar Bajpai, who was our ambassador in Washington. Rasgotra, who was a foreign secretary. So I was Dikshit, who was my boss in Colombo. So I had the good fortune to work under some very, really good people. People who took care to teach you something consciously, mm-hmm. you know. So I would say they would have impacted me. But there were a lot of people I would meet, you know, of other ministers or other countries.
Yeah.
I mean, I'm old enough to have actually sat in a meeting with Andrei Gromyko and, and separately with George Shultz.
No.
So when you actually see somebody like a Gromyko or a Shultz of that era operate, it's
all right. Now, this is my last question. Since you brought up multiple choice questions, I'm going to give you a multiple choice. You can either confirm, deny, or neither confirm nor deny. Is the party prepping you to contest the Lok Sabha election next year?
I have no idea.
That's not part of the options, by the way.
it doesn't follow any of your... my Rajya Sabha is due this year.
Oh, nice.
So I would suggest watch my Rajya Sabha.
Okay. Ladies and gentlemen, the External Affairs Minister of India, Dr. S. Jaishankar.
Well, that was a fantastic session. I think Dr. Jaishankar deserves a much rounder applause. And please, can we like bring down the house? Wonderful to see so many people at the News18 Rising India. Thank you so much, Dr. Jaishankar. And I'm going to request Zakir to present a memento to the Honorable External Affairs Minister.